Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, the station which you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Mr. Mwangi Francis, and I'll be taking you through chemistry form 2. Basically, we are going to look at structure of an atom. Subtopic will narrow down to chemical formula. So stay tuned and do follow the lesson through. So what are the goals of this lesson? The goals of this lesson, we just have one goal. Specifically, by the end of this lesson, you'll be able to write chemical formula of compounds. How do we write the chemical formula of compounds? And why is this very important for us as chemistry students? So compounds range from different substances. We have salt, sodium chloride, that is sodium. The formula we have there, sodium atom and chloride atom bonded together. We also have magnesium oxide, basically used mostly in manufacturing of antacid tablets. We have the formula there, magnesium bonded to oxygen. We also have other compounds that are gaseous state, like carbon 4 oxide. Basically, it is there in the atmosphere forming a given percentage, which is 0.03%. And as you can see, we have carbon atom bonded to oxygen atoms. So how do we get to write this chemical formula? But we should first try to understand what is a chemical formula. It's a notation which is used to show the number and type of atoms present in a compound. So using the atomic symbols and numerical subscripts. Therefore, it tells us how many atoms are there of each element bonded in a given compound. Remember a compound? Two or more substances which are chemically combined. So what is the ratio of their combination? The other thing we need to know is that it describes a substance down to the exact number of atoms which makes the compound, which makes a compound, that is the number, the ratio, as we had said previously. So how do we write a chemical formula? Number one, we should know the element or the elements in the compound. We can't write the formula if we don't know the elements. Number two, we should know the correct symbol of the element or elements in the compound. And lastly, the valency, which we defined in our previous lesson, the combining power of elements, very important. It will guide us in writing a chemical formula. Example one, write the correct formula for the table salt, commonly known as sodium chloride. So, sodium has the scientific name natrium, hence the symbol Na. We don't use SO, that's why we must know the correct chemical name, scientific name of these compounds. So the combining power of sodium is positive 1, that is its oxidation number, and the combining power, the oxidation number of chloride ion is negative 1. So first thing, identify the ions of the element. The other thing, once you identify their ions and their oxidation state, cross multiply the valencies. That is sodium, you interchange the valencies, you cross multiply the valencies. And this gives us sodium chloride requires one chloride ion, while chloride ion requires one sodium ion to become stable. And that gives us the formula NaCl, sodium chloride. Number two, magnesium fluoride. Correct symbol, magnesium Mg. Fluoride, that means fluorine, which is an atom. Atomic number 7, electronic configuration, atomic number 9, electronic configuration 2-7. Valency of these elements, we have magnesium and fluorine. As you can see, we have the ion there. The oxidation state is indicated. So we cross multiply the oxidation state. That is magnesium, one magnesium ion requires one fluoride, requires two fluoride ions, while one fluoride ion requires, one magnesium, sorry, requires two fluoride ions, while one magnesium atom requires one fluoride ion. From this illustration, you can see that magnesium has a valency of 2, while fluoride has a valency of 1. So when we cross multiply the valencies, we get one magnesium atom bonded to two fluoride atoms. that is giving us the chemical formula. It is important for us to consider radicals. So what is a radical? This is a group of elements that exist together with a net charge. There are several examples, but in this case we look at the following. Carbonate, you can see the composition, one carbon atom bonded to three oxygen atoms, and they have a net charge of negative 2. We have nitrate, sulfate, ammonium. We have other examples like nitrite, nitrate itself, sulfide, carbonate, sodium hydrogen carbonate, that is hydrogen carbonates, phosphate, etc. So they are very, very important. So can we be able to write the formula of zinc sulfate? Now you see, we have the sulfate as a radical, which we had previously here. So sulfate is a radical, a group of atoms existing together with a net charge. So this will guide us in writing the formula. We know zinc is a transitional element with a valency or with oxidation state number 2. Sulfate ions themselves, as you can see, they have their own net charge of negative 2. So by cross multiplying, this indicates that 2 zinc atoms or ions are bonded to 2 sulfate ions, 2-2. By simplifying this ratio, it gives us one single atom or ion of zinc is bonded to one sulfate ion. And there we have the formula, that is zinc sulfate. It is important to note that when we have a subscript in a radical, we add parentheses so that we can clearly indicate that the ion itself is what is required. So let's see whether we have got the goals of this lesson. Try to write the following chemical formula of the following compounds correctly. We have potassium chloride, lithium oxide, and magnesium carbonate. You can refer to this book, Students Book 2, Chemistry, and as well as Patel. Most importantly, visit us on, send us an SMS through the number on your screen, or give us a visit at YouTube or Facebook at Erimu TV. Give us a tweet at @ErimuTV_KE. Please do stay attuned to the lessons that follow, and you will learn much more. Thank you for watching.